Prince's passing, Tony Soprano has a table reserved at Holston's in Bloomfield, New Jersey, where he was last seen eating onion rings as the Sopranos series went forever to black. Don't stop. Now reporters are sitting at the reserve table.
For now, it's shut down.
Reporting on something much more final than a finale.
Oh, don't worry. I'm going to hell when I die.
How could a character with so much anger be so beloved, a son who abused his mother when she just had a stroke?
I'm going to live a nice, long, happy life, which is more than I can say for you.
A guy who got so annoyed at his table mate that he even abused the ketchup. A character who got into our heads while having his examined.
When's the last time you had a prostate exam?
Hey, I don't even let anybody wag their finger in my face.
And in real life?
First of all, have you ever had any personal experience with psychoanalysis?
Yeah. I don't think when I started the series I did. I think that led me right into it.
In the New York tabloids, it was Tony who died. James Gandolfini's real name got second billing. And all Gandolfini had to do to get a laugh was act like Tony when Tina Fey interrupted him on Saturday Night Live.
Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you.
Well, use your head.
That is the scariest man I have ever been attracted to.
But the real man was said to be sweet rather than sour.
What is your favorite word?
Pickle.
Cartoonist Mark Murphy wrote this epitaph. Here lies Tony Soprano, murderer, thief, extortionist, drug abuser, liar, arsonist. He was loved and will be missed. I've been missing the Sopranos show open. So let's make one last trip with Tony through the Lincoln Tunnel to New Jersey. Things have changed. Tony would definitely have switched from toll tickets to Easy Pass. The Twin Towers are long gone. And now, so is a towering actor. Jeanne Moos, CNN. Got yourself a gun. New York.